To find the collector-emitter voltage, let's assume the transistor is in active region. With that assumption, the base-emitter junction will conduct, and we will have a 0.7 voltage drop from the base to the emitter. And since the emitter is connected to the common ground, then the base will have a 0.7 volt. Now, since the base voltage is found, then we can easily determine I1, the current flows through the resistor R1. So the I1 will be the voltage drop across R1 divided by R1. As you can see here, the voltage at the base node is the same as the voltage across the resistor R2. So the current flows through this resistor will be the base voltage divided by R2. Now with the KCL, we can determine the base current IAB. As we know, the collector current is beta times of the base current. Now by knowing the collector current, we can find the voltage at the collector node by subtracting the voltage drop across the resistor RC from the supply voltage. The collector emitter voltage will be the collector voltage minus the emitter voltage. As you can see here, the voltage across the collector emitter is greater than the saturation voltage 0.2 volt. So the transistor is in active region. Therefore, our assumption is validated. I have other videos in reviewing transistor circuit DC analysis, which I will put the links under the video description.